Welcome back, everybody. Today on the workshop, we're going to be taking a look at another cool power tool from the folks at Rock and Rocker. They have sent over their 8.5-inch dustless table saw. It is model number PTSM08A. I'll make sure to have that in the description for you. But pretty much what it is a dustless, portable, 8.5-inch table saw. Works like a lot of other table saws with some different features. This one is a 15-amp sauce. You know, it's got plenty of power and it can run off standard house power. You don't need to have it on a 20-amp fuse. It spins at 5,000 RPM, uses a 60-tooth 8.5-inch blade. You can, of course, put different styles of 8.5-inch blade, but that's what it will come with. It has a 2.25-inch max cutting depth at 90 degrees and an 1.75-inch max cutting depth at 45 degrees. So I'm gonna start taking things out of the box. Let me grab a knife here. We'll see all what's inside. We'll do an actual unboxing. Let's take a look. We're gonna work on this out in the garage today because if I run a table saw in the house, I will be murdered. I don't wanna run it in the model shop because I have fresh paint drying. So we'll start taking it out. This is as new to you as it is to me. First, we've got a giant piece of styrofoam at the top. Just fight with that and throw it onto the side. Ooh, all right, we got all metal top on here. Everything seems pretty much pre-assembled. Just get that out. It's not lightweight, that's for sure. We've got the saw itself now on the side here. And its power cord, its motor, we'll take a look at that in a moment. We've got, looks like a Rock and Rocker dust bag. We've got a dust hose. We've got a fence. Looks like the fence is pretty much pre-assembled. We've got a safety push tool for pushing small media out of. And then we've got a box of parts here. We got a loose screw in there. I've got a few of those, so we won't worry about that. And that's it, so let's throw the box to the side. Let's open the little box. Do you guys see where I put my knife? No? Neither did I. There it is. All right. Open up the little box. And we've got more styrofoam because that's what the world needs. We've got some instructions. We've got a random metal piece with screws in it. We've got, this looks like safety. Yep, we got blade guards here. All kind of complex blade guard. We've got another metal piece. We've got another angled metal piece. Man, got some knobs and screws. Durable. We got more, these look like anti-kickback teeth is what they look like to me. Or split teeth that push the board apart when it reaches the end of the saw. We got more screws. We've got a bag of wrenches. So clearly we'll be putting some stuff together here. And these are for changing blades most likely as well. Got possibly a hose holder. Plastic. Got a miter gauge, which is excellent. Always got to have that. And that's it. So everything that's in the box so far, we got miter gauge, anti-kickback, and material splitters that go at the end of the saw loser. We've got two random pieces of metal. We've got another piece of metal, which is likely the mounts for these safety guards over the blades. Wrenches, more plastic than OPEC. We got some bolts for holding stuff together. We've got our handle, which I can only guess is to move the blade up and down. Got our fence here, our dust hose, a random loose screw, a dust bag. That's what I'm guessing this is. Yep, because this end slides open. It's a dust bag with a spongy with a spring tip on the end, so that will collect the dust. Our pusher, and then this beast of a saw. more styrofoam. So let me get things unpacked, grab the instructions, find out what everything is, and I'll be right back. All right, with that slideshow, we've got the saw all assembled. I wanted you to see how I install the separator and the blade guard and the hoses for the vacuum. Something that was not covered in the instruction manual was what this little plastic tool was for. I thought it was a hose holder, and I was correct. This keeps the hose out of the way of the blade. If you're going to be cutting things off either side, it depends on which, you just simply pull it out and move it over to the other side of the saw, and it holds steady. So you can decide which side you're going to be cutting. Also, some smaller things that we saw when we unboxed it, I didn't know what they were. Now I know what they are. These small aluminum rails here, these are part of your fence system. We'll detach the fence by pulling up and removing it. You'll see these holes here are for attaching these fences. It's covered in the instruction manual. When you want to cut much smaller material that you might want to pinch between the two pieces of the fence or smaller stuff like that, these are what you would use for precise work like that when you're working on small pieces of trim and small pieces of wood. We're not going to be doing that here, and that'd be more extensive woodworking advice and stuff like that, so you can do that on your own. The fence is a nice one-piece affair. All metal construction except for the handle is comfort plastic with a nice grip on it. This just snap locks onto the bench. It's got grooves in the front and the back, and you just place your tongue in the back and your solid metal piece in the front with your little red guide wheel to tell you how many inches or centimeters you're going to be cutting. You just lock it over and push down, and wrenches will fall off the table. Nothing else will. I mean, nothing's going to move. The fence isn't going to slide. It doesn't move at all when I push on it. So that locks into place. You can go in here, you can pull it across, and you can go back and forth. So the only thing I see so far is that the scale for your measurement here is in millimeters. Companies do make the inch ones that you can just stick on in its place. But given that most of the world works in millimeters and centimeters now, that's how it goes. But you can replace this with an inch ruler if you want. To give you an idea of the size of the table saw, we are looking at the table itself, not all the attachment points, 18 inches deep and 24 inches wide. So a foot and a half deep, 2 feet wide. We've got this additional fence here that sticks out from the side that can be removed and moved to the other side. You also have an attachment point over here on the side of the saw for your rip tool. And that's what you will use when you want to rip items that are narrow. You can push them through. You go right through next to the saw blade, next to the fence, and push your material till it falls out the back so that you don't ruin your fingers and you don't have to go buy one. I have a whole bunch of these things around because it's great to have them. But that just locks into place on the side when you're not using it. You've got your miter gauge, anywhere from 45 to 45, 90 in the middle, with its little gauge in there. And that positively locks into the table saw. So you see it's not gonna come out. That allows you to loosen it up, adjust your angles, and it allows you to do your cross cuts at your different angles through the saw. And there's a groove right here on the saw if you wanna cut on the right-hand side of the blade. So you don't have to always cut from the left, even though I always do. You can also cut from the right if you desire. So we've seen the fence. We've seen how that attaches, just up and down, and you can lock it. And then you can also fine-tune that fence with this screw here to tighten it down and lock it down and make it really, really hold tight. We've got our height and angle adjustment for the blades here. You simply eyeball it, and your guard will drop down with it. And you can lower that completely beneath the table. You can remove the guard with just that flip switch that I showed you to attach it. You can pull off the suction hose and you can attach that to the side of the table saw over here if you want. You don't have to. If you want to haul it this way, that's fine. And then you just raise the height. And you can see that the guards and the suction for the sawdust and everything move with it. This wheel here, you loosen up this knob, and this wheel here allows you to adjust the angle of the blade. There is a gauge here from 0 to 45 degrees on the front, and then you just simply turn that where you want it. We'll put it right on 0. We'll tighten that tri-bolt, and we know that it is straight up and down. Now, you should always confirm this with a square of your own. I'm not going to teach woodworking techniques, but that's how you do it. The on-off switch, very easy to use. It's got a big paddle switch. There's your off switch. There's your on switch. When you have the dust bag attached, if you don't have it attached to a vacuum system, that's why you don't need a vacuum system. You've got this all with you, and it creates its own vacuum with an actual motor down there. You just put your safety switch down. You press your green button, and the saw fires up. We'll watch that bag inflate. And when you power it down, it collects all your sawdust, and then all you have to do to empty it is gently pull it off that attachment, take it over to your garbage area, slide this off, and the end of the bag comes wide open. And that's it. That's all there is to this saw. Super easy to use. It should catch most of the dust. No saw made will catch all of the dust. When you want to change blades to ripping or cross-cutting, not just general use, the instructions tell you how to do so. I'm not going to go over changing blades because it has one attached to it. These are your wrenches for doing so. Like I said, we've got these different fence attachments. The fence itself, when you want to haul it, simply detach it from its clamp. There's a little rider on the side, and you just snap it down in there, and you're ready to go with it on the side of the saw. So I'm gonna go get some simple materials you would have on the job site to slice through. We'll see how powerful it is. We'll see how it cuts. What I'll do now is I'll practice some cross-cutting with just a standard 2x4, very typical of any job site. Always confirm your measurements with a square that you know is square, and then set up your tool, tighten it down, and start your cutting. I've got the blade set to its maximum height. I always like to have it as high as possible to give the teeth a chance to go around. We'll turn it on. You go ahead and wear the safety equipment you want to. I wear safety glasses and hearing protection when I use this stuff, but I am not teaching that either. So you do what you want. We'll just run some stuff on the cross cut. A nice 2x4 stud, 1.5 by 3.5. We'll see how it goes through that with its powerfulness. wait till the sauce stops. Real thin pieces like that will get stuck in here. That's why you want to wait. Let's adjust this to a small angle here. And we'll go 60 degrees. I'm not used to a table saw that collects its own dust, so here, I should have moved this over. We'll do that again, we'll slide that down. I like leaving the bloopers in because everybody makes mistakes. So we can see that it cuts real well, extremely clean. Doesn't burn the wood. That's a big sign that you have an okay blade on there and that the saw is more than powerful enough. We didn't hear it slow down and it did not burn any of the wood on the cuts. And there is not sawdust everywhere. It's all in the bag. We don't have a big mess up here. We don't have sawdust chips flying all over the shop or anything. That's pretty awesome. So reset my miter. We know it can cut across that stuff just fine. Pull my fence out. Let me set up the fence. Let me get some material to rip and we'll see how it does when it rips. Okay, so we've done the cross cutting. Very powerful, works just fine, and it manages to suck the blade dust and the dust from underneath with its larger hose and blow it all into the bag. So we should be good there. I've got the fence set up, and this is because I'm using it on a portable table, but we got the saw all ready to go. One feature I wanted to let you know if you're cross-cutting big material, I almost forgot, there's little set screws underneath here, and you can slide your table up quite a ways. You see? And you can adjust that with your set screws there, and you can slide that table out another foot. So let me put my hose holder back in. We got one there and one there. So move it all the way over here. That keeps the hose out of the way, which is a neat idea. And then I will start up the saw. We'll start some rip. Well, that went through it really easy. Straight edge, no burning, no chipping, plenty of power. Let's move it in a little bit. We'll rip another one down. And there we go. Smells beautiful in here. It's catching all the sawdust for me. There's a little bit of sawdust, but it's not a lot. The saw works beautifully. I can't believe, even with that 60 tooth blade on it, it didn't even burn across the knots there. That's a really clean cut. Very, very powerful. Don't forget to use your pusher, which just locks on the side when we're done with it. And that's it, folks. That's the saw. We've looked at all the features of it. I've got a special little tool that Rockin' Rocker wants us to look at next. We're gonna take this out. It's just a little bitty thing. I'm gonna show it to you and then we'll wrap up the video. So as long as we're out here looking at cool tools, they said, will you do this with it? Because you can't get it, it's so small, you really don't wanna do its own video. And I said, sure. So we're testing the table saw. We've got this cool thing. It is their 3-in-1 digital angle gauge. That's the part number. I will link down in the description for the saw and the angle gauge, but this thing is pretty cool. We'll open the box. Got this cute little carrying case. got a USB charge cable, and it's got the instruction manual. Got a little charge cable there. We open up our little case, and we've got this adorable little angle gauge all set up, ready to go out of the box. What it does is it has lasers on either end that you can activate, and it will tell you at what angle you have a surface at. So you set it up here, it'll tell you what angle it is. You set it up here, you set it on an angle, you set it up here, and it's handy for all kinds of building or working equipment and stuff like that. So we'll turn it on, and it automatically starts to find the angle, and it has little arrows that tell you whether that end is facing up or that end is facing down, and it depends on which way you turn it. So you put it on your surface, now it's reading perfectly level, and then if you press the on buttons again, it will activate lasers that you can see off both sides, one or the other, or both sides. So you can see, and it will give you your angles at the other end. So you can raise it up and down and say, at what angle is that picture going to be, or what angle is this floor? We're looking at 4.65. We set it down 0.35. If you know you're perfectly level, you can zero it out with the gauges. Obviously, we're on a table saw, on a table, on a floor. You can check the grade of your concrete floor and see what percent grade it is. For those that need to know what percent grade something is, or what level something is, or if they want it to be perfectly level somewhere else across the room, that's how you do that. It's a cute little gauge. I will link to this in there. It's got the double lasers. You don't have to replace the batteries. You just plug it in with the USB port on the back. It's got its own little carrying case. You just hold it to shut it down. It self-calibrates. It's easy to use. The instruction manual really isn't even needed. It's so simple, but it will explain to you how to hold your data and do all the different functions in there. So we thank Rock and Rocker for sending over the table saw. We thank them for sending over that cute little digital angle gauge. And I will see all of you at the next reviews.